Look at my shiny crystal balls! Aren't they beautiful? Don't you just want to pick them up and touch them? Okay, that's getting a bit weird with the whole balls thing. I got these crystal globes from AliExpress. I've put a link in the description. The out-of-the-box behaviour is pretty boring, so I've done a bit of work and created versions that are controllable by the amazing WLED software. At the moment, I've just got them running in a colour loop effect, but I've also got a microphone. So what I can do is I can switch into the microphone effect. So let me just find that. So there we go. I've got it switched into a user mod that now responds to the microphone input. So that's really pretty cool. They're pretty good. So very nice bits of kit. But let's dive into the electronics that's underneath it all and makes it all work. So let's have a quick look at the original PCB that came from AliExpress. It's pretty simple. We've got three resistors and six LEDs, and it's got a simple on-off switch. So not particularly exciting. The power comes directly from the USB, so we've got the plus and the minus coming on here. Let's just check the voltage across the LEDs. So I've got my multimeter here, and let's just try and poke in here and see what the voltage is across the LEDs. So I can actually get in. Okay, so it's just under 3 volts. And we've got our 5 volts coming in from the USB. Let's just check that. Yeah. Well, 4.6 volts. Interesting. So that says to me there's quite a lot of voltage drop across this cable. But let's bring in the fairly simple schematic. So we've got 47 ohm resistors, and there's three of them, so 47 divided by 3, so that's about 15.7 ohms, and we've got 3 volts across the LEDs, so then we've got 2 volts across here, which means the current should be 2 divided by 15.7. So about 127 milliamps. So then we've got 6 LEDs. So it's about 20 milliamps per LED. Let's just double check our calculations. So I've assumed 5 volts going across here, but when we measured it, it was quite a bit lower. So let's just let's pull in the USB tester. And see what the current actually is. So just plug this in. Plug that in. So we're actually getting about 0.11 amps. So 110 milliamps. So it's not drawing very much current at all. I think this cable might be a bit shonky because the voltage we're measuring on the actual PCB is a lot lower. So let's just zoom out and measure that again. So according to our USB tester, we're getting pretty much bang on 5 volts from our supply. Let's measure what we're actually seeing on the PCB. 4.5. So yes, I'm going to say this cable, pretty rubbish. So that's their fairly simple schematic for their PCB. Let's have a look at what I've done. So here we go, quite a bit more stuff. So the main thing is the ESP32 S3 Mini. So that lets us use the amazing WLED software, which is fantastic if you've not tried it. Give it a go. We've got a microphone, so we can do audio responsive LEDs. So that makes that pretty flashy. For driving the LEDs, I've used this driver chip. That was inspired from the LED curtains that I took apart a while back. Now you can just take one of these LEDs and use it as a sacrificial driver, but these tend to need 5 volts to come in, so I've got a nice driver chip just to level shift the output from the ESP32, which is a 3.3 volt device. The other interesting things, there's a jumper here. So I've designed this board to be fairly flexible. So the LEDs can either be powered directly from the bus power coming in, so from the USB or battery, or you can power them from an external input, so I can drive quite a few LEDs from this board if I give them their own separate power supply. There's a battery charger, so a TP4057, so we can make this all battery powered, so that's pretty good. What else do we have? Oh yes, the power path. So let's actually look at that in detail, because this is quite an interesting circuit. So this is currently one of my favourite circuits. It's really quite clever. So let's imagine we have a battery connected, so say that's at 4.2 volts, and we connect in 5 volts from USB. So we have 5 volts coming in. It comes into the gate of this PMOS transistor, and it turns off this transistor because 4.2 volts, which is flowing through the transistor, is lower than 5 volts, and our gate source threshold isn't crossed. So this PMOS turns off, and that blocks the battery from supplying any voltage. Our USB voltage carries on, comes through this diode, comes up here, and it flows into our voltage regulator, which then comes out as 3.3 volts to power our system. So when we connect 5 volts to USB, it's blocked from the battery, doesn't touch it. It could be very dangerous to connect 5 volts directly to the battery, and that doesn't happen because it's blocked by both this PMOS and by the body diode of the PMOS. So that's great. But what about the other case where we're using battery power and USB is not connected? So let's draw that case. So in this situation, we may have 0 volts on USB, or it may not be connected at all. And we've got 4.2 volts, say, on our battery. So what happens? USB is not connected. It's pulled down via this 100K resistor. So this now gets pulled down to 0 volts. That goes onto our gate of our PMOS. Now at the same time, we have our battery voltage that comes through here, and it goes through the body diode of the FET and comes to here. So now our gate source, our gate is lower than our source. So the MOSFET turns on and the battery voltage comes straight through the MOSFET and comes through here, supplies our 3.3 volt regulator, which then supplies 3.3 volts to our system. Now it can't flow back into the USB because we have this diode here, which blocks it flowing back. So even if our USB is connected and just not powering anything, the battery voltage can't flow back into the USB. It just flows into our 3.3 volt regulator. So it's really quite a clever circuit. I really like it. So as always, I got my boards manufactured by the guys at PCB Way, because I really didn't fancy trying to do some of these tiny components. In particular, these LED indicators. I mean, that's just way too small for me to bother with. Life's just too short. But it's a great job. Everything's soldered on nicely, including the USB socket, which I always struggle with. So yeah, thanks PCB Way. Worthwhile getting the assembly done if you're willing to spend the money on it. It saves a lot of effort and time. So the very last thing I wanted to check is the actual current draw of my PCB. So I've set the LEDs to maximum brightness. So I've just put in 255, 255, 255 for the RGB. And we're drawing around 230 to 240 milliamps. So that's not too bad given that the ESP32 is using Wi-Fi and we're driving the LEDs at maximum brightness. So that's not bad at all. The last thing is I do have these little indicator LEDs for showing battery charging. So let me bring in the one that has a battery so I can show that. So let's plug in here, and our battery is fully charged, so it's showing green. Actually, my battery was turned off. So I've turned the battery on. So I've just connected the battery using this switch. And now it's charging the battery. The indicator light
turns red. When it's fully charged, it will turn green. And there's also another LED in this tri-color LED, so we can also do the blink sketch if we really want to. And of course, the other thing to point out is when we're charging the battery, obviously the current draw is quite a bit more, so that's about 400 milliamps, so maybe 420 milliamps when charging the battery. So that's pretty cool. I have got WLEDs wired up, so if I push one of the buttons, which one is it? That should turn off the LEDs. So now we've gone down to just 300 milliamps, and that's charging the battery, and the ESP32 is listening on Wi-Fi for instructions from the WLED software. So the last thing to talk about is the base. So from AliExpress, they come with this fairly basic wooden base. It's quite nice. You could actually sand this down and varnish it and get quite a nice decorative piece. But I've ended up 3D printing a bunch of bases. I've used this silk PLA. It's come out kind of okay. I'm not completely sure about the color. What I really wanted to do was try some nickel plating. Unfortunately, my attempts didn't really work that well. So this is an attempt at nickel plating a 3D print. If you hop over to the extras channel, you'll see a complete video on that and my experiments. It kind of worked, but not well enough to really use. Although, it doesn't look that bad. I don't know. What do you think? Let me know in the comments. Anyway, that's this project kind of done.